This is a tour of the cervical vertebrae model with the spinal cord. Here's a cervical vertebrae. Here's the vertebral foramen. So the spinal cord goes through the vertebral foramen of the vertebrae. Here's the body. And then lateral to the body, we have a transverse foramen. That's where the blood vessels are going to go through to supply the brain. So over here, we have our cervical vertebrae. We can see the spinal cord that's in the vertebral foramen. We know this is cervical because it has a bifurcation on the spinous process. This is on the posterior or the dorsal side of the body. And the body of the vertebrae is on the anterior side. So that helps us have orientation. Between the vertebrae and the spinal cord, we have some structures we need to talk about. So underneath the periosteum is going to be the epidural space. This is where if you get an epidural, they inject it in here. And then we have the meninges. The meninges are three layers that are going to protect the brain and the spinal cord. So the outermost layer is called the dura mater. It's tough. Then we have the arachnoid. Underneath the arachnoid layer, we have the subarachnoid space. There's cerebral spinal fluid that flows through here. Here we have the pia mater. The pia mater is a very thin layer that covers the spinal cord. The spinal cord has white matter that has myelinated axons. And then we have gray matter that's in the shape of a butterfly. And in the center, we have a central canal. It also has cerebral spinal fluid. Our gray matter has posterior horns. They're on the posterior side. It has anterior horns because they're on the anterior side. The spinal nerve has sensory and motor neurons, and they are going to enter the vertebral column through the intervertebral foramen. It's just a hole in between the vertebrae. The dorsal root ganglion, or posterior root ganglion, has the cell bodies of the sensory neurons. The axons of the sensory neurons are going to continue to the spinal cord through the dorsal root and enter at the posterior horn of the gray matter of the spinal cord. The posterior horn is going to house the sensory neurons and the cell bodies of the interneurons. The interneurons are going to synapse with the motor neuron. The anterior horn is going to house the cell bodies of the somatic motor neurons, which will innervate the skeletal muscles. The axon of the motor neuron is going to leave the spinal cord through the ventral root. And the axons are going to enter the mixed spinal nerve and then take the signal to an effector.